What's up, guys? Chris here with some philosophy, and today, again, we're talking about something young trainers should know when coming into the fitness industry. So today's comment is from Joshua Aaron, and what he said was, be humble, put ego aside, and be hungry for knowledge. And it's funny, you would think in the fitness industry, it'd be easy to be humble, but in all honesty, it's one of those ego-driven industries where everyone's about, look at me, look at me, look at my physique, look at the way I look when I'm in the gym, look what I'm wearing, look at my clothes, look at my outfits. There's so many things that people use to help themselves feel better about themselves as far as fitness professionals, being a coach, being a mentor, or whatever. So being humble is not the easiest thing for people, especially if you walk in a room and if you're a huge guy or a girl who's in phenomenal shape and everyone's giving you attention all the time. So you walk into the room, your arms are showing, your chest is showing, whatever. If you have your shirt off, they see your abs. And automatically, that's going to draw attention because it's not normal to average people. And I mean average people by people who aren't in the fitness industry. So when you walk in a room and you're shredded and everyone's staring at you and asking you, hey, what do you do for your arms? Hey, what do you do for your chest? What do you do for your abs? What do you eat? What kind of supplements you take? And we all know, we've all been to the family party or a friend's house at a cookout or whatever, and you show up and they're like, right away, they see the way you look, your physique, and now all of a sudden you get all this attention. And it goes back to, I know Kanye had a line where he said, it's hard to be humble when you're stunting on a jumbotron. When you have all that attention, it's very difficult to be humble about it sometimes. Sometimes you start, that feeds your ego and you're like, oh, I'm this person, I'm someone special. And yes, we're all special in our own way. But when it comes to this industry, be very cautious because male and female, that eventually is going to fade. What I mean by that is there's only so long you can be the biggest, strongest, fastest, toughest, roughest guy. You see it in every sport. People are the best, they're the greatest, they're on this pedestal, and then they hit a certain age and things just start to diminish, which means you as the fitness professional or whatever industry you're in, you have to change your game. And one of the examples I like to look at is if you look at someone like Kobe Bryant, if you look at someone like Michael Jordan, as they aged in their industry, they went from high flying, dunking on people from all over the gym and crazy moves to let me learn this post game. Let me be a little bit more intelligent with where I spend my energy or where I spend my time. Let me train a little bit harder. So they realized in their careers that as they got older, their game had to change. And if you watch their careers, you see like, wow, yeah, when they were younger, they were dunking over people and everything else. And as they got older, now all of a sudden they're working on their post moves. They're letting the game come to them a little bit more, expending less energy, putting in less minutes in the game. It comes to us as fitness professionals or whatever industry you're in, you have to change your game. What does that mean? A couple ways you can change your game. First and foremost, as mentioned on the comment, you have to always be learning. So what new things can I bring to the table? Okay, I can't bench 400 pounds, I can't squat 1,000 pounds anymore, my knees are shot, my shoulders are shot, whatever the issue may be. Now I need to be a little bit more intelligent with my training program. Maybe my physique isn't selling anymore. I'm not the biggest, strongest person, or girl-wise, I'm not the leanest, sexiest body in the gym, but I have the intelligence. Maybe I have a different tool. While you're gaining your clientele with your look and everything when you first start the industry, later on it's got to be a different approach. So now you approach it from the angle of I'm the most intelligent in a certain way. Maybe I studied movement and all my clients are doing mobility and movement stuff. Maybe I started studying yoga and transitioned from the lifting crazy heavy to more of the yogi lifestyle and I'm promoting yoga. Maybe I divvied off and went into nutrition. And now I'm more of a nutrition person versus the great physique in the gym and focus more on the nutrition part. Because that information, that intelligence you learn from that, no one can take that away from you. The intelligence you learn about movement and mobility and the crazy exercises, or there's just the basic exercises you learn using that, that's not going to fade away. So start putting your stock in things that don't go away. If all the stock is just in your physique, that's going to fade eventually. But if your stock is more in building up your mind, building up you as a person, building up on personal development, that stuff's gonna stay with you forever. So maybe you become really great at scheduling and teaching people how to block their day. Maybe you become a life coach and focus on improving people's lives. Maybe you start speaking more and become a presenter. All these other avenues you can take in the fitness realm. So you have to continue to learn, but the only way you're gonna learn and absorb the information is if you're humble enough to receive it. And if you have your ego driving you in one direction, you're not gonna be able to have that humility and the things you need to gain the information, to gain the knowledge, to move in the opposite direction or just a different direction. Thank you, Joshua, for the comment. That's our philosophy. We'll see you guys next time. Peace.